There's your family and everybody.
Good. 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 Good.
Has a few words for us this morning. We'd like to play our national anthem.
Thank you.
We have a few announcements. Behind you is the baseball card show, and they were very generous to share this space with us. And any of you that can visit there, they can show their food and to show their appreciation for us. Up in front, we have some tables. If you want to leave your sons or your daughters' addresses, we're going to try to get people to write to them and let them know that we care. And I think it's great that you're letting people know you care. Now we have Linda Stopp, from the co-founder of Pie That Binds, that would like to speak to you for a few minutes.
Temples, VFW halls. The next meetings are in Waterbury this Tuesday night, Simsbury on February 6th, and Meriden on February 21st. We welcome all family members affected by Operation Desert Storm to join us. Our third area is somewhat on hold with the request of the military. We encourage letter writing to our sailors and soldiers, and in the past we have participated in sending packages of goodies. But due to operational necessities, the military has requested that all packages be held so that military supplies can get through, but your letters are still welcome. Before I turn this over to my co-director, Eileen, I want to say a personal thank you to each and every one of you for coming out today. The wreath is actually a bunch of artificial branches shaped in a circle with a bunch of colored ribbons tied in knots on it. And the flags that line the walkway were actually a bunch of wood or aluminum poles with colored fabric attached to the tops. But that ceremony, like this gathering today, is much more than a bunch of poles and bows and fabrics and colors. Cheshire, there's a fire burning in our American spirit. That fire makes those red, white, and blue bows and flags glow with the pride of the greatest nation in this world. Every man and every woman stationed in Saudi Arabia right now has that fire burning in their American spirit. They are enduring what many of us can't even imagine. Cheshire, we are the fuel for that fire. Let this country glow with the pride of our American spirit. Let it shine forth and fuel the American spirit of all of our loved ones in Saudi Arabia. Thank you.
15-year Cheshire resident. He is a veteran of Vietnam. In Vietnam, he flew an A-6 intruder with the United States Navy. Flying over 70 missions in Vietnam, Norman has a little bit of a closer tie today than a lot of us do, in that his son, Scott Guymon, is also a lieutenant in the Navy today, flying an A-6 in the Persian Gulf. I'd like to turn it over right now to Norman.
Thank you very much. It does my heart good to sit up here and see all the folks who turned out for this cause. When Dave asked me to speak, I said I would be more than glad to. Part of that is the experience that I had as a Vietnam veteran. What I didn't do, and I'm glad I'm here to be able to do it now, is speak out enough back when I should have. When I came back to Vietnam in 1968, I was amazed at what I saw going on in the United States. And it was demoralizing to be a veteran, to come home, and find that you felt that your country didn't appreciate what you were doing. It's been a long time working with that thought, and my feeling is that I don't want my son to come home to that. There's no reason that he should. There's no reason that any of your sons and daughters should come home that way either. This kind of outpouring is the kind of thing that they need. And none of us like war. I'll be the first one to tell you that. And all the veterans that I see here in front of us, I'm sure feel the same way. War is not fun for anybody, no matter what side you're on. But the young people who grew up in communities like Cheshire, graduated from this high school, and unselfishly had a sense of duty, or have a sense of duty, to serve in the military, they deserve the appreciation they should get. They're running in harm's way. The intensity of what's going on there is tremendous. As far as I'm concerned, it's worse than what I ever saw. And it does my heart good, as I say, to have us come out. They need it. I'm sure that in the back of their mind, as they've grown up, the thought that they exist, as they've seen the movies that have come out, Born on the 4th of July, a few others, they've looked at the press coverage that existed during the Vietnam War, and in the back of their mind, they must be thinking that, I wonder if that's how I'm going to be treated when I come home. We don't want that. I don't. Let's continue to show the support. We all want it to end quickly, and I thank you very much for coming out on a cold day and showing your support. Let's keep it up. Thank you.
Situation, but the one thing that unites us all is our support for our troops. They're there for us. Our nation's like a sea of diversity. It rages with our ideals, and it comes before the unity of our flag. That's what makes our country strong, is that we all have differences of opinions. But what weakens them is when we are indifferent. Today we're not only here to support our troops, but in some small way to pay penance to our veterans, for remaining silent when others spoke, for remaining idle when others degraded them, for not thanking and honoring them, for going forth in our name and suffering the pains that they have. But we're going to change that today, because we're going to show our support for our troops. We're going to thank them. And I just hope that this spirit continues on throughout the conflict, because you are right in what you feel. We won't get into what we think of this man, but he has to be stopped. And you're not wrong for what you feel. Stay with it, stand strong, and be counted among the majority that you are. Thank you. May have read in the paper this week.
Thank you. God.
How did we get it up there?
Not in there.
Bodies may sicken, so do our houses sicken. And what of madness? If mad people live within, doesn't this madness creep into the rooms and walls and corridors, the very boards? Don't we sometimes sense that madness reaching out to